1 week ago, I installed a package of bees for the first time, and it went really well. So today, I'm going to perform my first hive inspection, and I'll be looking for three main things. Firstly, I want to know if the queen is alive, and if she's laying eggs. The queen is the most important bee in the whole colony, because she's the only one that can make more bees. Secondly, I want to see if the bees have eaten all of the food that I gave them, and maybe even give them some more food. And lastly, I want to see if the bees are making quality comb, and remove any comb that isn't built off of the plastic frames. This will ensure that the hive remains serviceable over time, and ultimately make keeping the bees easier. So after removing the lid, I decided to give the bees some smoke to stay on the safe side. The smoke works by interfering with their communication, which confuses the bees and makes them less likely to fly around. I then removed the spacer, which is just another hive box, and I now had a really good view of the hive. I could immediately tell that the food I had provided last week was all eaten, and even the can of syrup was empty. So I removed the can and gave the bees a little more smoke to drive them further down into the hive. Next, I needed to remove one of the outermost frames, which would make room for me to manipulate the remaining frames. I placed this frame on the frame holder, attached to the hive stand, which allows me to prevent hitchhikers from getting onto the frame. Next, I wanted to check on the queen cage, which is where we had last seen the queen, and there were a lot of bees on it. However, none of the bees were the queen, and they probably were just attracted to the cage because it smelled like her. After shaking the bees off, the cage was empty, and I put it aside for a future project. I then pulled out the frame which was next to the queen cage, and I noticed a lot of abnormal comb on it. This was probably caused by the extra space between the frames that I had left for the queen cage, and it needed to be removed. But first, I wanted to locate the queen, because I couldn't be sure that I wouldn't hurt her if I made a mistake while removing the comb. So I put that frame back for now, and continued my search for the queen on the next frame. This frame had a lot of bees on it as well, and I was beginning to get concerned that I wouldn't be able to find the queen. However, it also had a fair bit of drawn out wax, and so I started looking for eggs and larvae, which are a strong indicator that the queen is alive and may be nearby. I was super excited to spot some bee larvae, and I knew that the queen was at least alive recently. After a more thorough scan of the frame, I was able to spot the queen without too much trouble, and I now knew her exact location. She also looked a lot larger than she did when I first got the package, and I think this means she's being well fed for. For fun, I looked around a bit more and found some fresh eggs that the queen had laid. They looked like little grains of rice, and the black foundation makes them a lot easier to see. Now that I had located the queen, I could safely remove the abnormal comb, and so I pulled that frame back out. The excess comb was only attached to the frame at the top, so removing it was easy, and I noticed that it was already filled with a clear sticky substance, which may have been the liquid food that they consumed earlier. As I examined the freshly removed comb, I noticed something that was quite disturbing, but it really wasn't much of a surprise. You see, over the last few days, I had noticed a handful of carpenter ants on and around the hive, and they were clearly interested in the resources kept within. I'll show you in a future video how I intend to deal with the ants, but for now, I won't worry about it too much, because there were only a few ants, and it's supposed to rain for the next week, which will reduce the ants' foraging behavior for a while. So now, with our three main goals accomplished, I decided I would look at the remaining frames so that I could get a good baseline comparison for next week, and so that we can see the hive's progress over time. As I continued the inspection, I noticed a cool behavior that the bees were doing, and I wanted to show you. It's called festooning, and it's where the bees all link legs to form long chains. This behavior is often observed when the bees are building comb, but it's still not fully understood why exactly bees do this. Anyways, I saw on the next frame that the bees were drawing the wax out nicely, and at this point, I was feeling pretty good about the state of the hive. I was really amazed at how calm the bees were, and they didn't seem to care that I was messing with their hive at all. On one frame, I saw the bees doing their waggle dance, which I thought was pretty cool. If you look closely, you can see individual bees shake and vibrate their whole bodies for short periods of time. This behavior is a form of communication, and it helps other foragers find good flowers. I've seen about everything that I needed to during this inspection, so I'll give the bees a break and wrap things up. But before I do, I decided to give them a fresh jar of feed to help them get more frames drawn out faster. If you enjoyed this video, or you want to see more weekly updates on this hive, please subscribe or leave a comment down below. I hope to see you next time, and thanks for watching.